Thank you, Alessandra. Let's start with the motivation. Say we have a protocol that takes expected constant number of rounds, and think about geometric distribution. What's going to be the expected running time of n parallel executions of that protocol? It turns out it's theta of log n. And just to get a feeling why, think of coin tossing. Say we want to toss a coin until it falls on heads. We expect that two coin tosses will be sufficient, because that's the probability to get heads, half. What happens if we toss n coins in parallel? Then in the first round, half of the coins will be heads, and another half will have to toss again, and so on and so on, and we get a logarithmic blow up. Why do we care about protocols that take expected constant number of times? Well, most secure protocols use broadcast. And fast protocols for broadcast take expected constant number of times. That means that when we have a broadcast channel where all parties talk at the same time, we can't use these protocols. Otherwise, the round complexity will blow up. And these protocols have a probabilistic termination property. We don't know when they are going to terminate. In addition, there's no simultaneous termination. Parties may terminate the protocol at different rounds. And this is kind of a nightmare for composition. We want the broadcast protocol to be secure regardless of the protocol that uses it, regardless of the environment in which it runs. So we want composition. And known solutions for parallel broadcast, for example, don't provide us composition guarantees. The main obstacle is how to simulate this property of probabilistic termination. And that's what we're doing in this work. We study universal composability of general protocols with probabilistic termination. And we give a framework that allows you to design a very, very simple protocols like you would like to in a modular composition style and compile it into protocols that has all this technical issues that involve probabilistic termination. And we give a few applications. We show how to get a perfect security and adaptive security for a Byzantine agreement and parallel broadcast with protocols that run expected constant number of rounds, and also for secure function evaluation with protocols that whose running time doesn't relate to the number of parties in the protocol. And just to emphasize, we give examples for perfect security, but our results also apply to statistical security or computational security. So after we talked about the end, we can go back to the beginning. We talk about multi-party computation. We have a set of parties, they want to compute a task, like compute a joint function, and we think of the dream scenario where we have an ideal functionality, a trusted party, that does the computation for them. And we want the protocol to emulate this ideal functionality by saying that no external distinguisher or environment can, that gives input to the parties and get the output can say whether they run the protocol or talk to the trusted party. In terms of security, we say that every attack on the protocol can also be simulated in this ideal model of computation. We have several communication models in traditional MPC. In the point-to-point setting, parties are connected in a full communication graph, and we consider a private communication. This is the secure message transmission functionality in UC. In a broadcast model, parties can talk over a bulletin board. I can post a message, everybody can see the message. And in both models, we'll consider synchronous communication. That means that the protocol proceeds in rounds. This can be achieved in UC if we have bounded delay on the channels, and also a global clock that synchronizes the parties. What do we know about feasibility of computation if we have a broadcast channel? Well, we have very, very good protocols. The classic results from the 80s give us perfect security, adaptive security, if sufficiently many parties are honest, and they provide concurrent composition. You can compose them in any arbitrary way you want, and security will remain. The round complexity only depends on the depth of the circuits that we compute. It doesn't depend on the number of parties. And there have been many follow-up works. We can even get the same properties by using only one round in which we use broadcast. And we ask whether we can get the same security and same efficiency if we only communicate over a point-to-point channel, where parties don't have access to a broadcast channel. How does a protocol that in the broadcast model looks like? So we have certain rounds where parties use the point-to-point channels. Everybody talk over point-to-point at the same time. This is parallel secure message transmission. And we have some rounds where parties talk over a broadcast channel together. This is parallel broadcast. And we want to instantiate this parallel broadcast in a secure manner to get a protocol over that is only over point-to-point channels. Standard methodology for getting broadcast protocols, if we have an honest majority, is to use Byzantine agreement. Each party has an input, and we require two properties from the Byzantine agreement protocol. Agreement says that all parties output the same value, and validity says that if all parties start off the protocol with the same input, this will be the output. Now, to get broadcast from Byzantine agreement, simply the sender sends its input to all the parties, and they run Byzantine agreement on these values. If we have an honest majority, that will be a broadcast protocol. We also know how to instantiate Byzantine agreement and broadcast using deterministic protocols. So these are protocols that have deterministic termination. We know at which round they're going to finish, and all honest parties finish the protocol together at the same round. We know how to get them with perfect security and adaptive security, and also with UC composition. The drawback is that the round complexity depends on the number of parties. So number of rounds is at least the number of bad guys that we have, that we can tolerate. And this is inherent. We can't get faster protocols using this technique. So if we have one round of parallel broadcast, it turns out it becomes many, many rounds in the point-to-point channels. Rabin and Benno showed how to get over this impossibility by using randomization. So we have a randomized Byzantine agreement. Feldman and Micali showed in the 80s a protocol that computes binary randomized Byzantine agreement from scratch without any setup assumptions. And the idea is that the protocol proceeds in rounds. In each round, each party has a bit. Initially, it's input bit. And each phase looks in a high level like that. So at the beginning, parties do a voting. They check whether the sufficiently many parties have the same input. If so, they terminate. The protocol will complete at that phase. Otherwise, they toss a coin, an oblivious coin. Oblivious coin means that with a constant probability, the coin toss will succeed. All parties will get the same bit. In that case, they will terminate at that phase. But with the complement probability, we have no guarantees. And the parties don't know whether the coin toss succeeded or not. This is the oblivious part. So with probability 1 minus p, the adversary can basically decide what's going to happen in that phase. Either the parties will not get to agreement and move on to another phase. That's one option. The other option is the adversary can make some honest parties think that they have reached agreement, in which case only a subset of the parties will terminate at that phase. In this case, it is guaranteed, however, that at the next phase, the remaining honest parties will terminate with the same input. So focusing on that again, the adversary can make some parties finish fast in one iteration, and all the remaining parties will finish in another iteration. So this is the non-simultaneous termination. Looking at it again, we have a probabilistic termination. We don't know when the protocol will end. And we don't have simultaneous termination. On the good side, the expected round complexity is constant because the each phase will succeed with the constant probability. And we know that we have a constant window of difference between termination rounds of honest parties. So this is good. We also have many improvements on this protocol. We can make it a multi-valued Byzantine agreement. We can get perfect security. We can also get a parallel variant of this protocol by Benorel and Yaniv. So looks like we have everything we want. What's missing? The problem is that all of these broadcast protocols are proven secure using a game-based definition. And we want composition. And composition follows from simulation-based definitions. Katz et al. Recently showed a framework where we can prove security of synchronous protocols over UC, but only if they have deterministic termination. And many subtle issues with probabilistic termination are not captured in that framework of Katz et al. That's what we do here. We extend this framework to deal with synchronous protocols that have probabilistic termination. So in the remaining of the talk, we'll go over this framework. We'll start at the first part of defining what probabilistic termination means in UC and show how to get protocols that are secure if all parties start at the same time. In the next part of the talk, we'll talk about non-simultaneous start, how to deal with that problem. And finally, we'll briefly mention some applications. So the main building block in our framework are objects called canonical synchronous functionalities, or CSF. CSF is a very simple ideal functionality. The main idea is to separate the function that we want from the round complexity that takes to compute it. So in a CSF, we only have two rounds. We have an input round and an output round. In the input round, all parties send input. In the output, they get the output. Each canonical functionality is parameterized by two functions. The first is the function that we want to compute, which takes input from all the parties and also from the adversary, and also a leakage function that reveals information on the inputs to the adversary. So at the beginning, a party sends input, the adversary gets a leakage, and so on and so forth. All parties send the input, the adversary sends its own input, and in the output phase, the parties simply request the output and get it. So it's a very simple functionality. Parties send input, and later ask for the output. It's simple, but it's very strong. We can model many tasks using a canonical synchronous functionality. So if you want secure message transmission, party I wants to send a message to party J, the function is simply a projection from the ith coordinate to the jth coordinate. If you want broadcast, party I broadcasts its message to XI, all parties, then the function is the projection from the ith coordinate to all coordinates. And secure function evaluation is simply we ignore the input from the adversary and compute the function that we want. But using CSF, we can also model tasks that are not a function, like Byzantine agreement. So if n minus t parties have the same input, this will be the output. Otherwise, we let the adversary decide what the output is going to be. That's very useful for simulating many broadcast protocols. The leakage in Byzantine agreement, for example, is the entire input vector because we don't want privacy with Byzantine agreement. So in the paper, we have many examples of instantiations of canonical synchronous functionalities. Once we have that object, we can define a synchronous normal form protocol, an SNF protocol. So these are protocols like we want them to be. All parties are synchronized throughout the execution of the protocol. All hybrids are CSFs in that case. And in each round, all parties call the same hybrid. So it's protocols that are like we know and love. We know how to deal with such nice protocols. As an example, think of the randomized Byzantine agreement protocol of Feldman and Mikali. So in the SNF form of that protocol looks like that. This is the skeleton of the hybrids that we are invoking during the protocol. At the beginning, we use secure message transmission to distribute the inputs of all parties. And then we have the phases. We toss an oblivious coin and do the voting. And in phases until we terminate. The problem is that most functionalities can't be instantiated using a two-round protocol. And a canonical functionality takes two rounds. So we define wrappers around a CSF that simply extend the rounds. So each wrapper, each such wrapper, has a distribution on the termination round. It samples the termination round where the computation will complete, and simply forwards all messages, all input messages to the CSF, and ignores fetch requests until the protocol, until the computation gets to the last round, the termination round. And this is, again, a simple wrapper. It doesn't have any much inside. Simply extend the rounds of the ideal computation. This is very similar to the framework of Katz et al. For deterministic termination functionalities. When we deal with probabilistic termination, it's a bit more delicate. So now we also have a distribution that samples the termination round, but this is an upper bound on the rounds of the computation. And in addition, we need to give the adversary the ability to decide which parties will terminate before others, to model non-simultaneous termination. So again, the wrapper samples the termination round, sends it to the adversary, forwards the input messages to the canonical functionalities, and then it starts getting output requests from the parties. The adversary can say, I want party I to get output now. In this case, the wrapper will give the party I the output, but not to other parties. So we have this non-simultaneous property in such a wrapper. All parties will get the output in either if the adversary says, give it to this party now, or if the computation gets to the termination round. So we have guaranteed termination here. Where do we stand with all these definitions? So we can now show without too much effort that the randomized Byzantine agreement of Feldman and Mikali implements the wrapped Byzantine agreement functionality, where D is the geometric distribution over the phases. And the protocol works in the parallel secure message transmission and oblivious coin hybrid model. And it is secure assuming all parties start the protocol at the same round. So pictorially, this is how it looks like. There is this issue that we assume parties to start the protocol at the same round, and if we want composition, this is a bit tricky. So that's the second part of the framework. What happens when we have fast parties and slow parties? So we have the two calls to broadcast, one after the other. Then we have a phase in between that can be overlapped between the two executions. And we want, this is very bad for security because fast parties will give information for the next execution before the slow party started the next one. We have solutions for dealing with this problem of Lindell et al., of Ben-Orlin and Niven, of Katz and Koo, but all of these solutions are focused on broadcast, on Byzantine agreement, and all of them use game-based definition for security. And we show a generic compiler that takes any synchronous normal form protocol and compiles it to a protocol that doesn't need a simultaneous start. So the compiler is parameterized by a slack parameter, C, and we assume that parties start within C plus one rounds. Parties are no longer synchronized throughout the execution of the protocol, so the hybrids are now being called concurrently. And we deal with that also. Then the compiler retains the round complexity of the original protocol. So that's a good feature. The main idea is to make that overlap between the execution meaningless. So we extend each round to 3C plus 1 rounds. These ideas are also being used in the previous solutions, but we had to slightly adjust them to make the simulation go through. So in the first 2C plus 1 rounds, the party listens and gets messages from other parties. In round C plus 1, it will send its message. And then it waits for another C message, C rounds, without even listening, simply waits. And to get a feeling why that works, so think of the example where C equals 1. So each party will start, all parties will start within 2 rounds. We have a fast party on the left, a slow party on the right. So first round, the fast party listens. Second round, the slow party starts by listening, and the fast party sends its message. So it will arrive at the destination. In the third round, the fast party listens and the slow party sends the message. And then the fast party doesn't do anything for 1 round. After which, it completed the first communication round in the original protocol. Next, the slow party doesn't do anything. And the fast party already started the next execution. So this is the concurrency issue. And we can see that messages are being sent as they should. Each party works in a locally sequential manner. So we have a local sequential composition of the protocols, but globally, we have concurrent composition. So that works well if the protocol doesn't introduce additional slack. But what happens with probabilistic termination protocols? Each protocol can bring additional slack of C rounds. And that can blow up the round complexity exponentially if we use that solution from the previous slide. So we use a technique that goes back to Bracha to reduce the slack between the parties to 1 round after each probabilistic termination hybrid. So we introduce another wrapper that deals with non-simultaneous starts. In the ideal model, it simply extends the round properly. Now we can illustrate the composition theorem. So if we have an SNF protocol that implements some wrapped functionality, when all parties start at the same round, then the compiled protocol that doubly wraps all the hybrids properly implements a doubly wrapped canonical functionality, and it can tolerate non-simultaneous starts of C plus 1 rounds. And the compiled protocol takes the expected same round complexity as the original protocol. So a bit about applications. If you want to take that broadcast protocol and run it n times in parallel, we know the round complexity will blow up. And we have solutions for parallel broadcast of Ben-Oreli Yaniv and Fitzig-Arai, and also Katz and Kuh gave such solutions. But actually, they implement a weaker notion of broadcast. They implement unfair parallel broadcast. That means that the adversary can corrupt senders and change their message based on the message that they were intending to send. And we show how to get parallel broadcast from unfair parallel broadcast using only secret sharing. Previous solutions of Hirt and Zikas used VSS. And using that, we can show that a doubly wrapped version of the parallel broadcast functionality can be realized in the secure point-to-point channels using expected constant number of rounds. We take that parallel broadcast instantiation and plug it into the BGW protocol, which is already in a way in a synchronous normal form, and we can get a secure function evaluation protocol that realizes the doubly wrapped SFE functionality, where the round complexity that only depends on the depth of the circuit in expectation. So to summarize, we show how to deal with protocols that have probabilistic termination. We can design and analyze protocols while completely ignoring these technical issues and compile it into protocols that will behave as we want. We gave some applications for protocols with perfect security, and we can also extend it to statistical and computational protocols, and that's it. Thank you.